Welcome to the fifth video in the acontis EC Engineer tutorial video series. In this video, we will demonstrate the remote connection possibilities of EC Engineer when working with an EtherCAT network controlled by a master running the acontis EC Master software. For this video, we have an EtherCAT network set up remotely in a lab, and we are working locally on a Windows system running EC Engineer. The EtherCAT network consists of a Linux system that is the master running the acontis EC Master software, and a variety of Beckhoff analog and digital slice I/O modules as slaves. On the EtherCAT master controller that is running Linux, we have a serial port connected to enable us to interact with the command prompt, one network adapter connected to the EtherCAT network of devices, and a second network adapter connected to the local area network. Since this system is remote in a lab, we will have a camera running to show the interaction between EC Engineer and the physical EtherCAT devices. On the local Windows computer, we have one network adapter connected to the same LAN. Note the IP address of the network interface connected to the LAN is 172.17.10.25. First, start the acontis EC Master demo application. We can set numerous options via the command line, and one important one for this tutorial is the -sp argument, which enables the remote access server, also referred to as RAS. The RAS server will enable access to the EtherCAT network from remote connections over TCP. Start EC Engineer and connect via the remote configuration option, specifying the IP address of the Linux system from before. When we click Select, EC Engineer will scan the EtherCAT network remotely by communicating via TCP with the RAS server running as part of the EC Master demo application. And there we can see all the discovered devices on the network. Because we don't need to do any other changes for this configuration, we can save the project and export the ENI file. We need the ENI file on the system where the EtherCAT master is running, so we will remotely connect to the Linux system via Secure File Transport Protocol, or SFTP, but you can use any method you prefer for transferring files to the Linux file system. In our SFTP client, on the left we have our local files on the Windows system, and on the right we have the file system for the Linux system. Copy the ENI file from the local Windows system to the remote Linux system. Now disconnect and close the SFTP client. With the ENI file now on the Linux system, stop the EC Master demo application and restart it, but this time also specifying to use the ENI file we just copied over. Notice that now the example application reports that it found the slave devices on the network and matched them to the configuration within the ENI file. So it will move through the EtherCAT state machine and set the devices into operational state. Without ever having disconnected EC Engineer, we can switch from the remote configuration mode we were in previously to the remote diagnosis mode by clicking the diagnosis button at the top. We can now see the current state of the network, and the slave devices are all green, indicating they are all in operational state. Let's switch to the topology view so that the devices within EC Engineer match the layout of the physical devices as we see them in the lab. Select the first slice module, which is an output module, and we will force the first output variable and observe the change on the physical device by the LED coming on and off, highlighted in red. Now select the third slice module, which is an input module that has a button connected to the input, and we will physically push the button and observe the change within EC Engineer. So there you have it. We successfully controlled an EtherCAT network affecting EtherCAT slave devices, all from within EC Engineer that was connected remotely via TCP to the master. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to our channel as we will be bringing you many more videos about EtherCAT. Please leave a comment below if you found the video helpful or if you have a question, and you can also get in touch with us on our website.